You're watching UNICEF television. UNICEF Global Head of Education, Dr. Kreem Wright, talks about how important it is for Myanmar children's well-being that they resume their education as soon as possible.
We are concerned, first of all, that children who have been affected as quickly as possible can be placed within safe and secure environments so that some amount of support can be given for psychosocial damage that these children may have suffered, but also that the learning process might start again, which for children is the best way and the quickest way of restoring a sense of normalcy for them, and also for giving time and space to their parents and to begin to rebuild their lives. Once you're able to put children somewhere safe, where they can be given food, where they can then start the business of play and recovery and learning, their parents then have the opportunity, that children are away from home for so hours a day, or from wherever, from camps, for so many hours a day, their parents then have the opportunity to think about rebuilding their lives, whether they're going to start their businesses again, whether they're going to apply for this, whether they're going to travel some distance to get supplies, whatever it is, they know that the children are somewhere safe for so many hours a day, and that gives a space and time for them to recover and start the process of rebuilding their lives. So education is important in both of those senses, but as far as restoring normalcy is concerned, giving food means people are no longer hungry. Putting shelter means people have some protection, but psychologically their lives are not back to normal until some kind of rhythm begins to return to their lives of children are going to school, they have time to do other things. So that's very important both for the children and for their parents in households. School starts again on June 1st, and most schools, of course, have lost all the materials they had, but we have supplies under what we call the essential learning package. Supplies for children, for 100,000 children, I think we have enough supplies that are being processed right now. So not only will we have shelter and a safe space for children to learn, but also the supplies that they need to carry on the exercise. But as I said earlier, we're also hoping that as part of the relief package, we can provide wind-up radios, which means that even if it's not possible to get full-time teaching going on, or for children to be in safe spaces, even from their homes, they can begin to listen to information for a start, but also get maybe playthings, rhymes, stories of hope in particular, stories of good triumphing over disaster, and then some formal lessons that they would normally have. You can do all of this without risking life and limb of people by simply broadcasting, and with a wind-up radio, they don't need the power because there's no power at the moment. So this can be a very powerful tool both for information and education.